Today's video is brought to you by Card Kingdom.
Hello everyone, it's Seth, probably better known as Saffron Olive, and it's time for another Instant Deck Tech. And today, we are ready to pioneer for a deck that plays some of my favorite cards in all of Magic. Cough, Satyr Wayfinder, cough. And that deck is Pioneered Wretch, a deck that is enabled by a new Core Set 2021 card that really makes this deck possible. And it comes to us from Pig Norton, who took it to a 5-0 finish in a Pioneer League on Magic Online. So congrats to Pig Norton on a really sweet deck. And let's talk Pioneered Wretch for Pioneer. So what is Pioneered Wretch all about? And like any good Wretch deck, step one is filling our graveyard. We just want to get cards in mass into our graveyard as quickly as possible because our deck is filled with cards that come back from our graveyard for free, generate value from our graveyard for free, or sometimes for mana. But anyway, we start off with self-mill. So we have Stitcher's Spire, Satyr Wayfinder. Stitcher's Spire just comes into play, mills three, can chump block, maybe mill three more. Satyr Wayfinder mills up to four cards, can also mill three and find us a land if we happen to hit one. So these cards put up some roadblocks in the early game to stop our opponent's aggression while filling our graveyard with our payoffs. We also have a couple of really powerful two mana spells. Gather the Pack, Grisly Salvage, both go five cards deep, can grab a creature or maybe two creatures. Grisly Salvage can also grab a land instead of a creature and put that in our hand. The rest of the cards go in our graveyard. So this gives us 16 cards that just dump cards in our graveyard, often while generating extra value, finding lands, finding creatures. So why are we so dedicated to stocking our graveyard with cards? Well, number one, and the reason this deck is exciting now, is Silver Smoke Ghoul. So Silver Smoke Ghoul, just a random little uncommon from Core Set 2021. But the big deal is, even though it's a 3-mana 3-1, we don't really want to cast it, ideally. I mean, we can if we have to. But the big deal is, if it's in our graveyard and we gained at least 3 life, Silver Smoke Ghoul just comes into play tap for free. We can also sacrifice it to draw a card. So if we know we gain the life and we don't have anything else going on, we can draw a card with Silver Smoke. It comes back anyway. So Silver Smoke Ghoul is a huge deal to this deck because it joins Narc Amoeba and Prized Amalgam to give us 3 different cards that essentially just come back from the graveyard for free. Narc Amoeba, if we mill it, comes into play as a 1-1 flyer. Prized Amalgam needs some help. It needs a creature to come into play from our graveyard. But with Silver Smoke Ghoul and also Narc Amoeba, we now have 8 things to trigger Prized Amalgam. So in a perfect world, we just like turn 1, mill cards with Stitcher's Spire. Turn 2, mill more cards with any of those 2 drops that can dump cards in our graveyard. And then by turn 2, we could be milling over like a Narc Amoeba to get back Prized Amalgams. We could be milling over some free life gain and Creeping Chill to get back Silver Smoke, which gives back our Prized Amalgams. So we can build a massive board really quickly. As far as getting back Silver Smoke Ghoul, which in turn gets back our Prized Amalgams, we have Creeping Chill, which is the best of the bunch. Just when we mill it over, we get to drain for 3. That 3 life triggers Silver Smoke Ghoul. Silver Smoke Ghoul coming into play will trigger our Prized Amalgams. So just milling a single Creeping Chill can potentially get us back, I don't know, 12 power, 20 power in the late game, which is very impressive. And then we have Uro Titan of Nature. Wrath, which gains 3 life when it comes into player attacks. We can just cast it from our hand to trigger our Silver Smokes, get back our Prized Amalgams, go to town. We can also mill it over and just escape it into play for 4 mana from our graveyard. So that's another nice upside. And because our deck is so focused on filling our graveyard, we have tons of escape fuel to exile to Uro. And that's the deck. That is the entire plan of the deck. Fill the graveyard, fill the graveyard, fill the graveyard, mill over stuff to come back for free with the help of our life gain stuff, build a massive board, use that board to smash our opponent really quickly. Otherwise, we have Deathrite Shaman. That's the last piece of the puzzle. It doesn't work directly with our deck, but because our deck is so focused on filling the graveyard, having Deathrite Shaman, which can gain us life, can drain our opponent, or ramp us, is very powerful because our graveyard's always going to be filled. Deathrite Shaman is a busted Magic card. The problem is it's narrow. You need to have a lot of fuel in your graveyard. Pioneer doesn't have fetch land, so it's harder to turn it on than in other formats, where in like modern, Deathrite Shaman is banned because it's so strong. But our deck fills the graveyard really quickly, so we should have plenty of fuel for Deathrite Shaman. It can ramp us into our Uros, can gain us a little bit extra life. 2 of them could technically get back our Silver Smokes with 4 life, and we can just drain our opponent for a little bit of reach in the late game. Mana base wise, 4 copies of a bunch of different lands, Blooming Marsh, Botanical Sanctum, a bunch of shock lands. One of the other things I love about this deck, and I don't know if you saw this as we were going through all these different cards,
Every single card in the deck, every single one is a four of. The deck is as four of-y as possible. Every single card. So it is nice and clean. No one ofs, no stragglers, very focused. As far as the sideboard, Thassa's Damping Sphere to deal with combo style decks, which are everywhere in Pioneer. Fatal Push for removal against aggro. Assassin's Trophy, Abrupt Decay, some catch all answers. And that is Pioneer Dredge, fueled by Silver Smoke Ghoul and friends. And that's been our instant deck tech for today. So thanks so much for watching. I hope you all enjoyed it, and I will talk to you soon. Need some new Corset 2021 cards? You can get them from our sponsor, Card Kingdom. Card Kingdom has Corset 2021 up for sale now. Check them out over at cardkingdom.com.
Thanks for watching the video. If you enjoyed it, help us out by clicking that like button down below. And to keep up on all the latest and greatest, click that subscribe button. And don't forget to hit that bell icon to get alerts whenever we have new videos. And if you want to, check out some of our other sweet videos here and here.